So what to derive this expression for the heat exchange in isobaric process. So what to use this relation between the CpCv, molar specific at constant pressure, molar specific at constant volume, etc. So at constant pressure we use this quantity, at constant volume we use this quantity, and these two quantities CpCv, they are related by Mayer's relation. Cp is equal to Cv plus R, where R is a universal gas constant. R is never zero, therefore Cp is always greater than Cv. So let us see this derivation. So last time we have seen the characteristics of the isobaric process. So pressure is remaining constant, and therefore on PV diagram you can show the isobaric process like this. Isobaric process. Pressure axis, volume axis. So pressure is remaining constant. So A is the initial state, B is the final state. This initial volume is the Vi, final volume is the Vf. So A is the initial state, it is described as, why we are calling it initial state, because change takes place from A to B, so arrow is important. So this is the volume expansion, final volume is more than initial volume. So A into bracket P Vi Ti is the initial state of ideal gas. We are using ideal gas. B represent P Vf, Ef is equal to final state of the ideal gas. So when gas is heated, gas is heated by supplying heat energy Q at constant pressure, at constant pressure. Therefore, volume and temperature increases. Therefore, work done W is equal to PdV is equal to P into final volume Vf minus initial volume Vi. But PV is equal to NRV. So pressure is remaining constant, N is the number of moles, R is the universal gas constant. So for initial state you can write down the equation P into Vi is equal to N into R into Ti. P into Vf is equal to N into R into Tf. Therefore this equation can give P into bracket Vf minus Vi is equal to P into Vf minus P into Vi is equal to N into R. For this we can substitute Tf minus N into R into Ti, and therefore this is equal to N R final temperature minus initial temperature. So this is dW or W. So W is equal to, either it is given by constant pressure, final volume minus initial volume, or N number of moles, or universal gas constant, final temperature minus initial temperature. So this is equation capital H. So this is the amount of work done. Now when the gas is heated, its temperature also increases, and temperature increases, therefore internal energy also increases. During isobaric process. During isobaric process, delta T is not equal to 0. Therefore, delta U is not equal to 0. Therefore, as temperature increases, therefore, internal energy U also increases, therefore delta U is greater than 0 and it is given by the internal energy. Sathi apan formula ha use karu shakto. We know this relation, amount of heat energy supplied to any substance is equal to mass of the substance multiplied by specific heat multiplied by rising temperature, where S is the specific heat. Now when we are using this equation for gaseous system, what are the changes? M is equal to mass of the gas is replaced by number of mole, S is replaced by molar specific heat at constant volume and delta T. So this is equal to N into molar specific heat at constant volume into final temperature minus initial temperature. So this is equation B. So we know increasing internal energy, we know amount of work done. So by using first law of thermodynamics, we can get the relation like this. Therefore, by first law of thermodynamics, by applying first law of thermodynamics for isobaric process, Q is equal to increasing internal energy plus work done using A and B. Q is equal to delta U is equal to N into Cv into Tf minus Tr plus N into R into Tf minus Ti. दोगे वैल्यू अपन इन टर्म्स ऑफ चेंज इन टेम्परेचर यूज के लिए. सो दिस ब्रैकेट इज कॉमन. सो क्यू इज इक्वल टू एन इंटू ब्रैकेट सी बी प्लस आर इंटू ब्रैकेट टी एफ माइनस टी आर. बट सी बी प्लस आर इज इक्वल टू सी पी मोलर स्पेसिफिक हीट ऑफ गैस at constant pressure. Therefore, heat exchange. Yathas formula apna derive karte hain. Heat exchange between system and surrounding. Between system and surrounding means environment. Q is equal to this N into this bracket is replaced by molar specific heat at constant pressure into final temperature, initial temperature, or this can be written as N into Cp into delta T. So this is equation C, like this. So first law of thermodynamics gives this result. When the gas is heated at constant temperature, so that temperature increases by delta T, then the amount of heat supplied or amount of heat exchange between the system and the surrounding is equal to NCPdT, where N is a number of mole. So N term meaning, but let's clear from the paper. N is equal to Cp, already we know here Cp is equal to molar specific heat, delta T is a rising temperature, N is equal to number of moles of gas, and delta T is equal to increasing temperature. increasing temperature. So the relation can also be used like this for solving the problem. Equation C dash. The CV आणि R माहिती असेल तर आपण हे पण इक्वेशन यूज करू शकतो. So either using equation C and C dash, we get the expression for the heat exchange during the isobaric process like this. So this isobaric process is shown on the graph by a horizontal line parallel to the bosom axis. Initial state, final state, and this is line parallel to the bosom axis like this. Now we have seen isothermal process. In isothermal process, temperature remain constant, and temperature remain constant, therefore there is no rise in temperature, so delta U is equal to zero. All the heat energy is used to perform the work done during the bosom expansion like this. So this is the isobaric process. Now we know isothermal process, we know isobaric process. Two processes are remaining. One is the isochoric, volume is remaining constant. Now gas is heated at constant volume. Actually chemistry मध्ये Mayer's relation derive करत असताना हे equation आपण use केलेले आहे. So next we will see isochoric process. So isochoric means volume is remaining constant. So definition can be given like this. A thermodynamical process in which volume of the gas is remaining constant is called isochoric process. Isochoric process. So what are the characteristics that we will see? Characteristics of isochoric process. First characteristic, since volume V is equal to zero, or volume V is equal to constant, therefore delta V is equal to zero, therefore work done W is equal to P dV is equal to zero. So no work is done by the system. Second characteristic, on PV diagram isochoric process is shown like is shown as in figure. So this is pressure axis, this is volume axis, and the volume is remaining constant. So A is the initial state, B is the final state, So for both the states, the volume remains constant equal to Vf. Pressure may change. So pressure is Pi. Pressure is Pf. So A is a initial state. B is a final state, like this. So pressure changes from Pi to Pf. Pressure decreases. Volume remains constant. So in this case, this is the version. Now, temperature increases when the gas is heated at constant volume. Temperature increases, so delta T is not zero. When gas is heated at constant volume, delta T is not equal to zero, like this. Therefore, delta U, increasing internal energy, is also not equal to zero, like this. And therefore, by first law of thermodynamics, Q is equal to delta U plus W, but W is equal to 0, therefore Q is equal to delta U, that is all the heat added, all the heat energy Q added is used to increase temperature and hence internal energy of the system. So this is the equation that can be used. 5. Example: heating of a gas in a constant volume container. Example 1. Heating of a gas in a constant volume container. Second, suppose we consider a container like this, and this is a compartment X. Compartment Y. Compartment Y. Gas 1, gas 2. So this is a semi permeable membrane. Therefore, gas 1 and gas 2 will diffuse through semi-permeable membrane. So that V1 plus V2 is equal to V is equal to constant. So V is the volume of the container. V1 is equal to volume of the gas 1. V2 is equal to volume of the gas 2. And V is equal to total volume of gas is equal to volume of container. So V is remaining constant. So diffusion of gas is the process taking place at constant volume. So these are the two examples. Gas is heated in a constant volume container, and there are two part of the container, compartment X, compartment Y. There are two different gases, so they can diffuse through this semi-permeable membrane, like this. So these are some examples like this. Now, in this case, again we are supplying the heat energy. So there is an exchange of heat between the surrounding and the system. So what is the expression for the gas? That can be easily derived like this. So just now we have derived the expression for the heat exchange during isobaric process. Now we have to derive the expression for isochoric process. For isochoric process, just now we have seen in characteristics, volume of the gas is remaining constant, therefore change in volume dV is equal to zero, but work done during volume change W is equal to E into delta V is equal to zero. That is W is equal to zero. This is the equation one. No work is done. That is no work is done during volume change. By but all the heat energy Q supplied is used to increase internal energy of the gas. Internal energy of the gas by delta U given by. Punatyaji question opponent karta hai. Amount of heat energy supplied is equal to mass multiplied by specific multiplied by rising temperature. So increasing internal energy delta U is equal to N into Cv into delta T. This is equation second. N is equal to number of moles of the gas. Number of moles of the gas. Delta T is equal to rising temperature. Rising temperature. And Cv is equal to molar specific of gas at constant volume. So equation 1 will W is equal to 0, equation 2 will delta U is equal to NCVDT, therefore by first law of thermodynamics by using first law of thermodynamics. Amount of heat energy supplied is equal to increasing internal energy plus work done using 1 and 2. So Q is equal to N number of moles into molar specificity at constant volume into delta T plus 0. And therefore, Q, amount of heat exchange is equal to, Q is equal to, or I will write down here, Q is equal to heat exchanged between system, the gas and environment. Environment means surrounding. Environment means source of heat. Burner अपन use कर रहे हो. System means gas. So Q is equal to heat exchange between the system, that is gas, and the environment, that is source of heat, and it is given by n number of moles into Cv into delta T. Delta T is the increasing temperature. So delta T is equal to Tf final temperature minus Ti initial temperature. Like this. So this is the expression for the isochoric process. मागच्याच आपल्याला एन सी पी डी टी मिळाला होता, इथे एन सी बी डी टी मिळाला होता. सो वी हॅव सीन थ्री प्रोसेसेस, आयसोथर्मल, आयसोबॅरिक, आयसोकोरिक. नाउ सो दिस इज द फोर्थ टाइप ऑफ द थर्मोडायनामिकल प्रोसेस दॅट वी आर गोइंग टू सी, एडियाबॅटिक प्रोसेस. सो द डेफिनेशन इज गिव्हन लाइक दिस, ए प्रोसेस a process, a thermodynamical process in which there is no exchange of heat between system and surrounding, that is environment, or in another way you can say that there is no transfer of heat from R to the system. System कडे हिट जात नाही, सिस्टीम कडून हिट बाहेर पण पडत नाही. सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन. नाउ कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ adiabatic process. For adiabatic process, Q is equal to 0. Process. No exchange of heat. For adiabatic process, heat exchange Q is equal to 0. Therefore, by first law of thermodynamics, delta U plus W is equal to Q, delta U plus W is equal to 0, or delta U is equal to minus W. One and the same. So it means that Q is equal to 0, so heat transferred to or from the system is prevented by using this third the heat transferred
टू और फ्रॉम द सिस्टम इज प्रिवेंटेड नॉट अलाउड इज प्रिवेंटेड बाय इंसुलेटिंग द सिस्टम फ्रॉम द By insulating the system from the surrounding, that is the environment. So, if this is the system. So this is a adiabatic bomb. This adiabatic bomb is shown by this type of symbol. Thick line and slanted lines are used. So this is also called as a non-conducting wall or thermic wall. So no exchange of heat energy. So heat contained remains constant, no increase or no decrease. This is say one example. The heat transfer to or from the system is prevented by insulating the system. So this is a insulator. Adiabatic wall means insulating wall, non-conducting or thermic or insulating wall. So coefficient of transmission T is equal to 0. Or the second way is this, the process is so rapid that there is no time for exchange of heat. The change is so rapid that there is no time for exchange of heat. It is a very rapid process. Isothermal process was a very slow process, quasi-static process. This is not quasi-static process, it is a rapid process. So usually there is a sudden change. So in this case, temperature changes delta T is not equal to 0. No heat is supplied, but there is a rise in temperature. हा टेम्परेचरमधला चेंज साठी जी एनर्जी येते ती कुठून येते मग तर ती सिस्टीमच्या इंटरनल एनर्जीमधली यूज केली जाते ती हलकत. सो द एनर्जी रिक्वायर्ड फॉर rise in temperature or change in temperature, change in internal energy, rise in temperature or fall in temperature or change in temperature is taken from
internal energy of the system. Internal energy of the system, like this. Example. Example. Sudden bursting of tire. Tire of a vehicle. When the tire bursts, there is a sudden change. Sudden bursting of a tire of a vehicle. So no heat energy is supplied or no heat is absorbed like this. 7. PV diagram. Characteristic of the hip on gear, sir. Pressure against volume diagram. So this is the adiabatic process. A, B. So process may be from A to B like this. So adiabatic process may be given like this, from B to A or A to B like this. So these are the characteristics of the adiabatic process. So this is the adiabatic wall. Now when we have explained the zeroth law of thermodynamics, there also we have used this type of compartment. So one more example can be given like this. Or system A, system B, environment. So this is the adiabatic wall. Adiabatic wall. No exchange of heat. No exchange of heat between A and B, system A and system B. So this represents the adiabatic wall, non-conducting wall, like this. So Q is equal to 0. In this case, Q is equal to 0. No exchange of heat. In this case, Q is equal to 0. No exchange of heat. Like this. So this is about the adiabatic process. And now let us interpret the adiabatic process for first law of thermodynamics. Now let us interpret this first law of thermodynamics for the adiabatic process. So already we have seen this equation, first point. For adiabatic process, heat exchange Q is equal to 0. Therefore, by first law of thermodynamics, we know this equation, delta U or W is equal to Q, but Q is equal to 0, and therefore delta U plus W is equal to 0, and therefore delta U is equal to minus W. So this equation is important. Interpretation means we have to interpret this equation. Now, so this is the equation A.
there are two cases of P question mark. Work done is positive, then delta U is negative. So we know that work done is positive during the volume expansion. But now it will be the adiabatic expansion. So third case. Example, during adiabatic expansion, delta V is greater than 0, therefore work done W is equal to PdV, work done is greater than 0, so work done W is positive, therefore equation A shows that delta U is negative. So we know the sign convention. Delta U is negative means internal energy decreases. So when, what is the result from this? W is greater than 0, delta U is negative. When work is done, when work done by the system during adiabatic expansion, W is positive, and energy required for expansion is used from internal energy of the system. Therefore, internal energy U decreases. Internal energy U decreases. Therefore, minus I. So this is one example. Adiabatic expansion. The adiabatic expansion is example. अपन कुछ लेते हैं तो sudden bursting of a tire. Second example. Fourth case. During adiabatic compression, W is negative, or you can go step by step. Compression means change in volume, delta V is less than 0, therefore work done is less than 0, so work done is negative. Therefore, equation A gives delta U is positive. That is, internal energy increases. Like this. So this type of arrangement is used in a refrigerator. That compressor is used in AC or refrigerator, and that compressor, the name itself suggests that it compresses the gas, and during that process the internal energy is released. So the internal energy of the system increases during the adiabatic compression, internal energy decreases during the adiabatic expansion. So these are the result. During adiabatic expansion, the internal energy U decreases. during adiabatic compression, the internal energy increases in the, like this. Now, in this case, there is no heat exchange between the system and the core. Here, we have to obtain the expression for the work done. The work done may be positive or negative. Also, there is a change in temperature. So, we have to find the expression for the work done during the adiabatic process. So, just now we have seen the properties of the adiabatic process. So, in when the system undergoes adiabatic change, no heat exchange, adiabatic change, then no exchange of heat. Therefore, Q is equal to 0. Therefore, by first law of thermodynamics, delta U, W is equal to Q, but Q is equal to 0. Therefore, delta U is equal to minus W. So there is a change in temperature or internal energy of the system. This is the question E. There is a change in temperature and internal energy of the system. This internal energy is used to perform work W during volume change. Therefore, work done W is equal to integration of PdV from initial volume Vi to final volume Vf. So this is equation say 1. Now, in the expression for velocity of sound by Laplace, we have used that gamma. So that gamma is called as a adiabatic constant, and for adiabatic processes it is used. So at constant temperature we use this relation P into V is equal to constant. So this is for isothermal change, Boyle's law. But for adiabatic process there is a change in temperature, and therefore this law is the modified. So, for isothermal change, P into V is equal to constant. This is Boyle's law. But for adiabatic process, for adiabatic change, P into V raised to gamma is equal to C is equal to constant. So that Boyle's law, Charles' law, Gay-Lussac law, all these laws are modified for adiabatic process. And all these equations, I will give that equation in the next lecture. All these equations involve this gamma. This gamma is called as the adiabatic constant, where gamma is equal to adiabatic constant. Already we have derived this value of gamma. Gamma is equal to capital Cp upon capital Cv or small Cp upon small Cv. For monoatomic, for diatomic and for triatomic gases, we have derived this value of gamma in the chapter kinetic theory of gases, next chapter, like this. So gamma is an adiabatic constant. So this is the question second. So remember, this is a very important equation. Some MCQ problem are also solved by using this relation. So now this equation can be arranged like this. So therefore, equation 2 gives pressure P is equal to C upon V raised to gamma. Put in 1, therefore W is equal to integration from initial volume Vi, final volume Vf, and this P is replaced by C into dV into V raised to gamma. So this is equal to integration now. C is a constant of integration. C is a constant. In this case, this C is a constant. So it is equal to dV V raised to minus gamma into dV from initial volume Vi to final volume Vf, like this. So now you can integrate this value. So we know this simple integration of x raised to n dx is equal to x raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So this n is equal to minus gamma in this case, and therefore work done is equal to C into the value of the integration is V raised to minus gamma plus 1 upon minus gamma plus 1, lower limit is initial volume Vi, upper limit is final volume Vf, like this. So this 1 minus gamma can be taken common, C upon 1 minus gamma, gamma is the adiabatic constant, into bracket 1 upon. अतः numerator अपन denominator ला नेला तर पुना term negative होने देते, so V raised to, this will become plus, this will become minus, V raised to gamma minus 1, Vi, Vf. Mathematical simplification पर अपन के ले लाए, मतलब सर. So substitute this. So we know the rule for solving the finite integration. Substitute variable is equal to upper limit, substitute variable is equal to lower limit, and subtract. And therefore, work done W is equal to C upon 1 minus gamma into bracket 1 upon final volume Vf raised to gamma minus 1 minus 1 upon initial volume Vi raised to gamma minus 1. Say this is equation 3. So work done in terms of this value is given like this. Now using this equation, you can write down the value like this. Using equation 2, Vi raised to gamma is equal to Pf Vf raised to gamma is equal to C. So using this value, you can arrange the term like this, sir. Rearranging the equation. Therefore, this C is replaced by C is equal to EI So W is equal to 1 upon 1 minus gamma into bracket C upon Vf gamma minus 1 C V raised to Vi raised to gamma minus 1. So using this value of C, so W is equal to 1 upon 1 minus gamma. And this C is substituted as this CG value of heat up. Vf raised to gamma minus 1 minus Vi gamma raised to minus 1. And this C is replaced by, this is the mathematical arrangement. Yeah, C cavity upon heat value substituted. Vf raised to gamma. Vi raised to gamma. आता सिंप्लिफिकेशन बघा. सो 1 अपॉन 1 माइनस गॅमा इनटू ब्रैकेट दिस इज वी एफ रेस्ट टू गॅमा माइनस 1 इट विल गो अप सो इट विल बिकम माइनस सो पीएफ इनटू वीएफ रेस्ट टू 1 माइनस दिस विल बिकम पीआई एज इट इज एंड दिस विल गो अप सो दिस इज इक्वल टू वीआई रेस्ट टू गॅमा Vi raised to minus gamma plus 1, so plus gamma minus gamma cancel. So this is equal to Vi raised to 1, like this. So this is the work done. W is equal to, so this is equation 4, but PV is equal to nRT, therefore this equation can also be written as work done is equal to 1 upon 1 minus gamma into bracket. This is replaced as N R TF minus N R TI. So N number of moles, R universal gas constant, 1 minus gamma. Gamma is adiabatic constant, final temperature minus initial temperature. So work done can also be given in terms of change in temperature. Like this. So this is equation 5. So equation 4 gives the amount of work done in terms of final pressure and volume, and initial pressure and initial volume, and final temperature. And so equation 4 and 5. Equation 4 and 5 gives expression for expression for work done during adiabatic process. Adiabatic process like this. Both equations can be used like this. If the change in temperature is given, use the equation for it. If the change in pressure and volume is known, from PV diagram, we know this value. From PV diagram, pressure against volume. So, this is the adiabatic process. E, VIPI, B, VFPF. So, the chain may be like this. it may be a reversible process. So this is Vi, this is Vf, this is Pi, this is Pf, like this.
So if Pi, Vi, Pf, Vf are known, use this equation, and if the temperature change is given, then use this equation. N is the number of moment. Gamma is a adiabatic constant. So we know the value of gamma. Now, this equation is important, P into V raised to gamma is equal to C. Using this relation, now here there is a change in pressure and volume, so it means that we are assuming that temperature is constant. So it is a Boyle's law for adiabatic process, like this. Yes, C by the Boyle's law will promote temperature in the lead. Temperature is remaining constant, like this. So that Boyle's law, Gay-Lussac law, and Charles law. For adiabatic process, they are used in different form. They can be derived from this first law, like this. So next time we will see this Charles law, Gay-Lussac law, and Boyle's law for adiabatic process also. On a single PV diagram, we will show all these four processes. Isothermal process, isobaric process, isochoric process, and adiabatic process. Adiabatic process and isobaric process. Adiabatic and isothermal processes, they have different slope. They are curved, they are not straight line. Why they have different slope, that's also we have to explain. It is not given in our book, but we will try for that. Okay, we will stop here.